next step is to design the reinforcement. First of all, we have to design the reinforcement for the maximum bending moment, which is hogging. This is a magnitude, 840 kilonewton meter is a magnitude of the bending moment, and we are calculating the cross-section area of steel required to bear this bending moment. And the area of steel we have calculated is 6288 mm square, and we are using 20 mm dia bars for the 6288 mm square cross-section area steel. And when we calculate the number of bars according to the given data, that is 20 point something, and we are taking it as round figure 21 number of bar, and we are providing these bars at the top face of the footing. Why top face of the footing? Because the hogging bending movement is maximum at the top face of the footing, right? So that is why, if there is a, this is a diagram of the footing, so bending movement will be like this, and to eliminate this bending movement or to bear this movement, we have to provide steel at the top face of the footing. So these bars also should be checked for the development length at the point of contrafracture to satisfy this equation. What is this equation actually? This is the bending movement diagram, right? So we have 2 point of contrafracture where the shear force will be zero, where the bending movement will be zero. And where the bending movement is zero, their shear force will be maximum. And we are providing steel like this. And this length should be equal to LD. This extended length should be equal to LD. So why we are extending this steel? Because at the point of contrafracture, due to maximum shear force, there are some chances to develop the cracks in the footing area, on the footing area, right? To eliminate that crack, we have to provide the steel to bear the this shear force, and the length should be sufficient, and that sufficient length is equal to development length, or it should be greater than to the development length. So that is why we are providing this check. So in our case, we have 2 point of contrafracture, but at the second point of contrafracture, which is near the column B, the shear force is maximum with this magnitude, right? And actual area of steel we are going to provide is 6597 mm square according to the 21 number of bars, and the percentage will be 0.8. And actually, this is the parameter to satisfy the development length check. So actually is equal to 176.9, and m1 here we are calculating, this equation is a moment of resisting equation for the m1, and we're calculating m1 is equal to 872.73 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm, and the value of vu, which will be shear force near the column B, is equal to 800-700 newton, and LD. LD is limited to D. D is an effective depth, or 12 into 5. The value of the phi is 20 mm. So whichever is greater. So what we calculated that the L0 is equal to 440, because the effective depth's value is a maximum rather than the others. So LD is equal to 47 into D, 47 into 5. So this 47 into 5 we calculated with the reference of M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. We often calculated in the previous numericals. And from this equation, we're just putting the calculated values in this equation and get the value 1530 mm. Hence, this it is the greater than the development length. So hence, we have satisfied the total requirements. So we have calculated the reinforcement for the maximum hogging bending moment. Now it's time to calculate the sagging bending moment, which is moment 3. So we will repeat the same steps for this calculation. We will calculate Bx, we will calculate Ast for required for the sagging bending movement, that is 1130 mm square. So here we are again, calculating the minimum reinforcement area, which is 0.12%, and that is 1578 mm square, but we have calculated that is 1130, and we will go with the minimum area required, and according to this minimum area required, this will be the spacing as 188 mm, and we will provide 180 mm center to center bars of 12 mm dia. So actual AST is equal to 1650 mm square, and the percentage is 0.14. Minimum requirement is 0.12, and the steel we are providing is 0.14% is sufficient according to the code requirements. So this reinforcement also should be checked for the development length. The same check we are providing here, a value of XU is calculated 31.5, value of M1 is equal to this, and VU is equal to same, will be, it will be remain same for the shear force near the column B, that is 800-700 newton, and again L0 is equal to D or 12.5, whichever is greater. Here the value of phi is the dia which we are using for the this sagging bending moment reinforcement. This is the development length will be remain same for the two materials, and it's 564 mm according to the 12 mm dia bar we are using for the sagging bending moment. And from this equation, what we get, we will get the value of this equation is greater than development length, hence we are safe in the same zone, right? So next is the reinforcement for the sagging bending moment, that is MU2 near the outer face of the column A. So we will again repeat the same steps, calculate BX which be equal to 1.32 meter, AST to minimum required steel, minimum area required for the steel is 792, so we will go with the same 792, and the spacing is 188 mm center center. However, we provide 12 mm dia bars, and actual AST according to this is 828, and the percentage of the steel provided for the sagging bending moment is 0.14, which is again sufficient according to the IS code requirement. So since please read this carefully. Since shear force 3 at the point of contour fracture, we have 2 points of contour fracture, C1. At C1, the shear force is F3. At C2, shear force is F4. So please read. Since shear force 3 at the point of contour fracture is less than shear force 4, right? So the condition of development length will be satisfied. So next step is check for the diagonal tension on one way shear. So it should be made in the cantilever portion at distance D from the face of the column B, that is D is equal to 440 mm. So the point of contour fracture being nearer, the more shear force will be at the point of contour fracture, right? So shear force at the point of contour fracture F4 is this, and distance at position F4 from the edge B1 is 5.70 meter. So the value of BX is equal to 2.5 meter. So we are again proceeding with the nominal shear stress formula, that is shear force divided by B into D. And this is the requirement of the IS code to calculate the toy C. So from this, what we get? We get the toy V is greater than toy C. If toy V is greater than toy C, so shear force reinforcement is necessary. So shear reinforcement we will provide according to the shear strength, which will not bear by the concrete, right? That is, so first we calculate the shear force which will be bear by the concrete, that is 528, which is not bear by the concrete, is equal to this equation. So we are using 10 mm dia bars, 8 leg strips, and cross section area of for the stirrups is 628 mm square, and the spacing for the bar is 356. This we calculated from the IS code 456 P73, and we get the result 365. So we know that the maximum center to center distance is subjected to 300 mm, but we are again calculating with the help of the formula that what should be the maximum center to center distance for the same, that is 226. So we will go with this instead of 300 mm. So hence provide 10 mm dia 8 leg strips at the rate 225 mm center to center. The next step is to calculate the transverse reinforcement. The footing will be bent transversely near the column faces. So the projection A dash 2 beyond the face of column B, that is from this to this location, this point to this point, this is A dash 2 from the column P's face, A dash 2 from the face of the column towards this point, that is equal to 1 by 2 into Bx minus B2. B2 is the width of the column B. So where the Bx is the width of footing at the center of the column B, where the x is equal to 6. So we can calculate Bx by putting the value of x in the equation we already have calculated, and the value of B2 is known to us, which is 400 mm. So here we calculate value of Bx, then A dash 2, that is 1090 mm from this to this point. Width of bending stirrup near the column B, that is D plus B2 plus D, that is D plus B2 plus D. So average area of bending strip is equal to, so 2.58 into 1.280 is equal to 3.3024 meters square. So this will be the average bending stirrup area. So net upward swell pressure according to this area, means according to this area, is equal to external load divided by the average area, is equal to 272.5 kilonewton per meter square. This is approximately 2.5 times of the value of the average pressure P, a maximum bending moment at the face of the column. So we have to calculate bending, maximum bending moment with respect to this length, right? So what it will be? It will be W into, it is actually W into L into L by 2. And for us, W is P into A dash 2 into A dash 2 by 2. So we'll get the value, factored bending moment, that is 161.88 into 10 to the power 6 into 1.5 newton mm. Now from the equation mu1 is equal to mu lem, we will get the effective depth required, that will be 297, but actual available depth is 440. It means the transverse beam of width 1.28 meter will be same thickness of the footing. Jo hamari footing ki thickness hai, wo 440 mm hai, jo hamari is calculation se zyada hai, iska matlab hamari 440 mm ki jo thickness hai, that will be sufficient to bear the transverse load. So we will calculate the reinforcement, transverse reinforcement. For that we will provide mu, which we have calculated for the transverse reinforcement, and the AST will be 1755 mm square. We will use 16 mm dia bars, and spacing of the bars will be calculated 114. We are providing 100 mm center to center. So similarly, we will repeat all these calculation for the column A at the width B from the center of the column. It will be like this. This will be the width B from the center of the column, and B1 plus D plus D. So we will calculate upward swell pressure for the average area of bending strip, and projection A1 dash, that will be projection A1 dash is this, and we have calculated the value, that is 0.53, and the area of bending strip is equal to 1.6048 mm, and upward swell pressure, obviously 600 is external load at the column A divided by the average area, is 374 kN per meter square. And we will again calculate the bending moment at the face of the column, that is 52.528 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. The factored value is this. So we are again equating mu is equal to mu lim, and what we will get? We get the effective depth calculated from this consideration is less than the D, 440 mm. So the value of the effective depth will be the same for the transverse reinforcement for the column A. So AST for the column A is 534 mm square, is the AST for the transverse reinforcement near the column A, and the minimum reinforcement is required 600 mm. We are calculated 534 mm. We will go with this. We are providing spacing according to this, and the steel of 16 mm tire bars at the rate 300 mm center to center. This will be the steel diagram. द स्टील जो हमने जितना हमने स्टील कैलकुलेट कर लिया वो प्रोवाइड कैसे करना है ये उसका डायग्राम है. थैंक यू.